down all our defenses to be with you. We lay down all our defenses to be with you. We lay down all our distractions to be wholly yours. We let down all our walls to be one with you.
Thank you.
striving. We lay down all striving here. We lay down our busyness to be draw near to you, to draw near to you.
Soul.
This is a cry of desperation. This is our confession of a longing. This is a cry for more, a cry for more of you, a cry for more of you. Spirit of the living God, come fall afresh on me. Come wake me from my sleep. Blow through the caverns of my soul. Pour in me to overflow. here in your presence, in a grace so relentless, I am won by perfect love, wrapped within the arms of heaven, in a peace that lasts forever, sinking deep in mercy sea, standing here in your presence, in a grace so relentless, I am one by perfect love, wrapped within of heaven, in a peace that lasts forever, sinking deep in mercy sea. I'm wide awake, drawing close, stirred by grace, and all my heart is yours. All fear breathe you in, I lean
Revelation 4. After this I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven. And the first voice, which I had heard speaking to me like a trumpet, said, "Come up here, and I'll show you what must take place after this." At once I was in the Spirit, and behold, a throne stood in heaven, with one seated on the throne. And he who sat there had the appearance of jasper and carnelian, and around the throne was a rainbow that had the appearance of an emerald. Around the throne were 24 thrones, and seated on the thrones were 24 elders, clothed in white garments with golden crowns on their heads. From the throne came flashes of lightnings and rumblings and peals of thunder. And before the throne were burning seven torches of fire, which are the seven spirits of God. And before the throne there were a sea of glass like a crystal. And around the throne, on each side of the throne, are four living creatures full of eyes in front and behind. The first living creature like a lion. The second living creature like an ox. The third living creature with the face of a man. The fourth living creature like an eagle in flight. And the four living creatures, each of them with six wings, are full of eyes all around and within. And day and night they never cease to say, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." And whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to Him who is seated on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before Him who is seated on the throne and worship Him who lives forever and ever. They cast their crowns before the throne, saying, "Worthy are You, our Lord, our God, to receive glory and honor and power. For You created all things, and by Your will they existed and were created."
sit upon the throne in all majesty and glory. Oh, there he sits upon the throne. There he sits. A storm
thank you.
to see what they saw. I long to behold your beauty. I long to see what they saw. I long to behold your beauty, God. Open my eyes to see.
With you where
me feel your embrace. Let me feel you all around me. Yeah, yeah. Jesus, let me see your eyes. Let me feel your embrace. Let me feel you all around me. Yeah, yeah. Jesus, let me see your eyes. Let me feel your embrace. Let me feel you all around me. Yeah, yeah. Jesus, let me see your eyes. Let me feel your embrace. Let me feel you all around me. Yeah, yeah. Jesus, let me see your eyes. Let me feel your embrace. Let me feel you all around me. Yeah, yeah. Jesus, let me see your eyes. Let me feel your embrace. Let me feel you all around me. Yeah, yeah. You long to see your eyes. You long to feel your embrace. You long to feel your
all around you. I know there are lightnings and thunderings. I know there's a storm all around you. Holy rains and thunderings. I know there's a storm all around you. Holy, holy, holy. I see the seven lamps of fire burning, and I see a sea of glass mingled with fire burning. I see the Son of Man with eyes like fire burning, burning, burning. I see the seven lamps of fire burning, and I see a sea of glass mingled with fire burning. I see the Son of Man with eyes like fire burning, burning. Oh, thunders all around you. I know there are lightnings and thunderings. I know there's a storm all around you. Holy, holy, holy. I know there are creatures all around you. I know there are lightnings and thunderings. I know there's a storm all around you. Holy, holy, holy. Oh.
that let the heaven come. Let heaven come upon us, God. With one voice we declare, the kingdom is yours, the power is yours, the glory is yours forever and ever. For you alone are our Father, our God, our Savior, the Creator of all. Lord God, we are here to come and in agreement with your heart. As we pray through Romans 11 now, let us stand here with you to intercede for Israel. Let us pray with one whole heart through your words that are spoken out towards your beloved one, Israel. Reveal your heart to us and let us draw near to you, closer and closer, as we intercede for your firstborn nation, Israel. We'll now be going into a time of intercession for Israel. We'll be declaring four prayer points from Romans 11 over the Israel. So I invite you to come in agreement with my prayer and follow up with your own intercession. Heavenly Father, through verse 2 of Romans 11, you said through Apostle Paul that you have not rejected your own people, whom you choose from the very beginning. Yes, God, we come in agreement with you that Israel is a chosen one and the beloved one of yours. So God, in this time, we pray that your enduring love, the endless love towards your people, will be revealed to them. The essence of your love will be visualized in their spirit, that it will cause overwhelming joy in their hearts. The people in Israel will sing and dance with a fresh reminder that they're chosen ones from the very beginning. God, we declare that they get to see and taste the depth of your love. Their hearts will be filled with thankfulness, and their praise towards you will be ever be on their lips, over and over again. Let's pray. Thank you. verse 5, you said, for a few of the people of Israel have remained faithful because of your grace and kindness in choosing them. God, we declare this over the Messianic Jews in Israel. We pray that as these Messianic Jews were chosen by you to be awakened by your grace, they will be clothed with the supernatural strengthenings of faith and protection. God, we pray that as they steward this truth of Jesus as the Son of God, the Messiah sent from the Lord, Holy Spirit will be encountered in their prayer times, and a deeper intimacy will be formed as they consecrate themselves to you, God. Let's pray. Salvation available to the Gentiles so that they can claim it for themselves. Jesus, we pray that your intention, your heart for Israel to be stirred up with hunger and thirst towards the salvation will be made, God. God, we pray that Israel will respond to your jealous love for her with a zealous love, God. Lord, bring the restoration into the heart of Israel, that she will confess you with wholehearted love as the God of Abraham, the God of Jacob, and the God of Joseph. Let the whole devotion to be made from Israel towards your name, the Lord God Almighty. Let's pray. Verses 26 and 27 of Romans 11, that Israel will be saved. It is your covenant with Israel
that you, the one who rescues, will take away their sins. Holy of the holy is your name, God. Jesus, you are the only Redeemer and the Savior. God, we declare that your words of mass salvation in Israel come to fruition. We pray for people to be awakened from their spiritual blindness and to receive the good news, to receive the revelation of Jesus, that he is the only one, he's the only one Messiah, God. God, we know your covenant is irrevocable by human hands. Lord, we want to contend your promise towards Israel. Lord, let Israel remain in your covenant, and it will be fulfilled, that the harvest of salvation will be gathered into the baskets of heaven. Let's pray. Agreement with your heart. Once again, we declare those promising words that you spoke through the Holy Spirit will be kept and fulfilled. Israel, as God's chosen one from the very beginning, strengthening of Messianic Jews who are chosen by your grace, Israel to become jealous for their salvations. And lastly, your covenant with Israel will be fulfilled. We acknowledge you and your faithfulness. Come and fulfill your words, God. We will stand by you, holding those words in our hands and our mouth. We pray all these things. In Jesus' name, amen.
Father, as we fix our eyes on the one who is seated on a throne, the one who's surrounded in glory, as we fix our eyes on what is happening in heaven, would you give us an increase of confidence and boldness, knowing, God, that you are a God who is almighty, who's all-powerful, and whose purposes will stand. We thank you, God, for your promises over your people. We thank you, God, for your promises over Israel. May we stand by your word that is everlasting. May we know that you are a God who will finish everything that he has started. We thank you, God, for visions of glory. We thank you, God, that you open up your scripture to us and you invite us in. We pray, God, that the same would be happening all over Israel, Lord God, even tonight, that people, as they open the Torah, they would know that there is a God who loves them, who made a way for them to come back to the Father. You would open up the scriptures, God. Would you open up Isaiah 53? Would you open up different scriptures where you talk about the Messiah that has come and that will also come? We pray, God, that your Holy Spirit will blow afresh on it. The spirit of wisdom and understanding would come upon your people, Lord God, that would behold your beauty, and that you would give them hope afresh. There are people that have not been forgotten. They're people of promise. They are people of covenant. We thank you, God, for what you have done tonight. We continue to trust in you, God. We love you. We pray all these things in your name. Amen. Amen. Thank you guys for joining us. We hope that you are blessed as we continue to just allow God to open up his scripture to us, that something would really be imparted and something would be transformed in our minds and in our hearts and our spirit. Yeah, we hope that you enjoyed it tonight, and we'll see you guys next week. We have a Wednesday morning watch at 9:30 in the morning. Otherwise, we'll see you again next week on Thursday at 8 p.m. Have a wonderful rest of the night, and we hope that you also have a wonderful weekend. We'll see you. Ha ha ha.